क्लास सिक्स बायोलॉजी चैप्टर थर्ड। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर लास्ट मीटिंग आई टोल्ड यू रिगार्डिंग द ब्लड वेसल्स एंड द ब्लड एंड व्हाट आर द सेल्स और कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ ब्लड आर देयर लाइक WBC, RBC। इन RBC वी डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द हीमोग्लोबिन एंड वी ऑल्सो सॉ द फंक्शन ऑफ द हीमोग्लोबिन देयर। Then we also learned about the platelets. Now our next topic is blood groups. Humans have four types of blood groups, and this was suggested by this Karl Landsteiner, who was an Austrian biologist and physician, developed the ABO blood group classification system. So our blood system or blood group system is called the ABO blood group classification. Or simply the ABO blood group system. So every human being has the blood group either A or B or AB or O blood group. Let us see how it was suggested. The students, a person who is having blood group A, so over the RBC, I'm just drawing the rough and diagram of the RBC. So over the RBC, there would be some biomolecules. So this is the RBC membrane. So at the surface, that is from the outside, there are certain biomolecules. And if the person blood group is, if I'm saying the person is A blood group, he is having A blood group, it means his or her RBC will be having a protein chain that will be called antigen A. Okay, so that will be called antigen A. Now if another person who is having blood group B blood group, now his RBC will also be having a sort of antigen. Now this time antigen I am drawing with the circle. Okay, so for example, if the chain is like this or if the protein is like this, so this will be termed as antigen B. Okay, now if a person who is having this AB blood group, so over his RBC we will see both the sort of antigen. So the circle one I told you the B antigen, and this chain sort of molecule I told you A antigen. Okay, so antigen A and antigen B will be found on the surface of the RBC of the person who is having this AB blood group. Now person who is having O blood group, his RBC will be having no antigen. Okay, no antigen means neither A neither nor B. Now let us see this table. So a person having blood group A will be having antigen on RBC as antigen A. So in short I have written, so let me just complete this one. So this is antigen, okay, GEN I'm adding over there. Likewise this is also antigen. Okay, so a person having A blood group will be having antigen A, B blood group having antigen B, AB blood group, then both the antigens will be there, that is antigen A and antigen B will be there. And if a person is having O blood group, it means he is having no antigen. Okay, now the next thing is that the person who was having blood group A, in his blood there will be antibodies named B. I told you antigens, they are present over the surface of the RBC, red blood corpuscles. But in his blood, in such a person's blood who is having blood group A, the antibodies will be there B. In the person who is having blood group B, the antibodies in that person's blood will be A. And the person who is having blood group AB, there will be no antibodies. Okay, there can be antibodies, but for some other infecting agent the antibodies can be there, but at least they will not work against A and B, means no antibodies are there. And then the person who is having O blood group, in his blood both A and B antibodies are present. Okay, So here no antigen I said in the this person's blood. RBC is having no antigen, but the blood is having both A and B antibodies. Now students, you know the antibodies, the function of antibodies, it is to kill the germs. Okay. The person with blood group O is called universal donor, and the person with blood group AB is called the universal recipient. It means if blood is required by the person who is having blood group A or B or AB or O, then this person can donate his blood. So this person can donate to the people who are having blood group A, B, AB or O. Okay. Their body can easily, this person's body can easily have the O blood group. Then we have AB blood group. The persons having blood group AB, they can receive the blood either from A or from B or from AB or from O blood group people. So that's why they are called as the universal recipient. So students, this is all for today. Goodbye.